Good afternoon, Warriors. I'm Kylie.
And I'm Avery.
And this is your Friday, September 4th feature edition of Warrior TV News.
On today's broadcast, we will take a look at the boys' soccer team,
get more familiar with the Warrior TV program,
and get to know what goes into Whiteland Community High School's new IU English class.
Hope when the moment comes, you'll say, I lived. Hope that you spend your days, but they all add up. And when that sun goes down, hope you raise your cup. Oh, I wish that I could witness all your joy and all your pain. But until my moment comes, I'll say, I did it all.
The boys' soccer team has been hard at work getting ready for this year's season. The players and coaches are planning on surpassing expectations. Meredith Cavallari, Aislinn Wynn, and Ellie Eisen get a closer look at what the boys' soccer team has been doing this offseason to prepare for competition.
The boys' soccer team is hard at work to make this season the best one yet. Warrior TV spoke with the coach and a few of the players to get their perspective and the goals that they wish to accomplish.
One of my biggest philosophies when I took over here was to try to get the team to be more of a possession type team and playing soccer like it should be played. My favorite part is just soccer is one of my biggest passions and being able to transfer that onto kids. One of my biggest things is the kids are having fun but also being successful, and I think that shines through in the number of kids we have coming out. We just have to work as a team. We've got a lot of talent, but like I always tell the boys, talent means nothing if you can't work together as a team.
After talking to Coach Van Horn about his goals for the season, Warrior TV dribbled their way over to the soccer field to kick it with some of the players and get their point of view.
I started playing soccer when I was 5 years old because I moved to England and it was the popular sport there.
I started playing soccer when I was 3, so I was too little to even know.
9 years ago, I don't know, my parents really just got me into it.
I started playing soccer when I was 2 because my parents just kind of put me in it, so I kind of went with it.
My favorite part about soccer is playing with the friends that I've played with for the last 6 years of my life. I've really built a bond with them, they're brothers.
Playing with my friends and winning games.
Playing with my friends, I really enjoy it. Yeah, we build tight bonds, and that's just what keeps us going.
Probably playing with my friends. We've been playing together since we were 3 and 4, so we've really got a tight friendship.
New changes that I've gone through is we've had to integrate the new freshman into our team, and Sean, we've had to bring him in, and he's been doing well.
Definitely getting new uniforms. Probably going to be one of our best years to put out and show what we've got.
Any changes, we got some new uniforms. They're pretty sharp, so looking fresh out there.
My goals for the season are to win conference and beat Center Grove in sectionals.
Definitely to win conference. I would like to win conference.
Something from last season that I want to improve on this season is to win more games and hopefully have a winning record.
I get a better record, for sure.
Definitely trying to keep my head when it's getting heated out there.
Definitely to beat Franklin. It's a big one.
I think soccer builds on teamwork and leadership because you have to have a team to be able to win games, and you have to have leaders out on the field to have a team.
I think it builds leadership. I'm the captain, so hopefully I'm doing all right.
Teamwork. Many of our players make mistakes, and due to that, you've got to keep your head, keep composed, and play confident.
I think soccer builds a lot of teamwork and leadership, working as a team.
Warrior TV wishes the boys' soccer team good luck as they kick off the season. Come support your boys' soccer team Thursday, September 10th at Franklin Community High School. JV kicks off at 5:30 with varsity following right after. I'm Asia Lynn, here with Ellie and Meredith, Warrior TV News.
Yes, we are family!
The theme tonight is Neon 80s. Come out and support the football team at 7 as they take on Decatur. Go Warriors! Many aspects of WCHS have been affected by this year's new schedule, including the Warrior TV news broadcast format. The radio TV program has made a significant amount of changes to their culture, including adding live broadcasts for the first time ever. Sam Tesser and Jeffrey Vorick went to Warrior TV students and staff to talk about the new changes.
The radio TV program has undergone a major change in its curriculum. Warrior TV went to the students and staff to ask them their opinions on this change.
I wanted to be in this program because I've watched it when I was a freshman on the news and stuff, and then I've heard people talk about it. And I never really knew what it was, but I took the class and then I figured out that it's pretty awesome, pretty cool.
I wanted to join this program because I saw like what they did on the news and stuff, and I thought it was really cool, so I joined it.
All my friends said that they were having fun doing it, and so I signed up, and now it's the best time of my life.
I wanted to be in this program because I like working with others collaboratively and making videos. That's most of what we do here.
Currently, we're working on the GI show. I'm currently doing a public service announcement, and I know there's going to be music videos and other things on this particular GI show.
My favorite aspect of this program is being able to work with others and getting to go out in the school and work with other students.
My favorite aspect is probably being around the people. Everybody's friendly here. We all get along. It's a pretty studious and a good environment.
The people in here, because it's such a great environment to be. It's like very positive and upbeat, and I just love that.
The switch to live broadcast is very, very beneficial. I think that no matter how many times we would pre-produce it, it would never be the same as if we live did it. And doing it live now, I think everybody understands like the stress and how much actually goes into a live broadcast, because you only get one chance.
And we're all just trying to figure it out still. It's been rough. We're getting there, though.
I like the switch to live broadcasting because it makes us look more professional, and that's what we need to move toward to become a more professional program.
After gaining insight from the students into the inner workings of the radio TV program, Warrior TV went to program director Mr. Clausen to gain further insight into the changes to this program.
I would encourage all WCHS students to consider taking radio TV because it's going to allow them the opportunity to dabble in some production opportunities that they otherwise may not have experience with, or if they're interested in this as a career pathway, this is a nice way to kind of get your foot in the door and start to do some really, really engrossing and really rewarding work in the field of video production.
It's given our students an opportunity to experience what it would be like to work in that environment. It's also a great service to our school from the standpoint of all the valuable information that you get out there for us.
The most important change and significant thing that we're doing differently this year is we are going live for the first time in the history of Whiteland Community High School, for the first time in the 12 years that I've been here.
If we are really looking to train our students to get into radio and or television, that adding that extra pressure of saying, okay, we're going live in a half an hour or we're going live in 5 minutes is more of a real world application. Going live allows you to feel that deadline, that pressure that you're going to feel if you're actually going to get into that business.
The radio TV students are hard at work producing content for the school. Be sure to tune in to Tuesday, Thursday, and the Friday feature broadcast. From inside the studio, I'm Jeffrey, here with Sam, Warrior TV News.
The last day to purchase your Red for Riley shirts. Shirts are only $10. Don't forget, it's for the kids.
Whiteland Community High School has been expanding their dual credit opportunities for the students. This year, WCHS has added an Indiana University English class that students can take for college credit. Jared Canary and Nolan Hanna pick up their textbooks to get an inside view about this new opportunity.
It's nothing new that WCHS is offering new classes for each passing school year, but something more interesting is the new IU W131 L202 English class. To get a more analytical insight on all the IU course has to offer, Warrior TV News went to its instructor, Ms. Lyons.
It's two semesters class. The first semester class is W131, which is the writing class. It's a prerequisite to L202, which is the lit class. Both are through IU University, so you earn your credits via IU. They're college accredited. And the first semester deals specifically with writing and how to write argumentatively. The difficulty for a student really depends on who they've been having for English teachers, and they've had great English teachers up to this point, so they should be thoroughly prepared, especially AP Lit students from last year. But really any senior, any incoming senior can take it because it gradually stair steps its way up, so you learn to get better as it goes on.
After meeting with Ms. Lyons to learn about the IU class as a whole, Warrior TV next asked some of the enrolled students about their thoughts on the course.
I decided to take the IU class because I wanted to get college credits while I was still in high school.
My favorite part about the IU class is that you get college credits for a high school class, which helps you in the future.
I would completely recommend this class to incoming seniors. It's a great value for your dollar. You're only paying $75 to get three credit hours at college, where at this point one credit hour at IU would run anywhere from $800 to $1,000, so you save a lot of money that way. You also have on your transcript now that you have college experience, and it might move you up so that you don't have to take this entry-level English class at whatever college you choose.
I would. It helps you become better at writing and just better analytical reader and writer.
Yeah, I would, because it gives you good experience in writing papers for when you might need to in college.
The IU students are hitting the books and strengthening their reading and writing skills. Juniors, if you are interested in taking advantage of this unique dual credit opportunity, be sure to talk to your guidance counselor about enrolling for the 2016-2017 school year. From inside the guidance office, I'm Jared, here with Nolan, Warrior TV News.
There's no school today.
Why?
It's Labor Day.
Okay, thank you.
Don't forget, Warriors, Labor Day is Monday, so we don't have school. Take the day off. You deserve it.
And that's all we have for you on this feature edition of Warrior TV News. Until next time,
have a good one.